Cause you're so sweet. I think I'm just gonna hold this shot. No, no, keep standing there awkwardly.
You're gonna need to bump this thing up if you're gonna be able to get that stage over there. But I guess we'll be fine.
We were fine when there was no mask. Want me to move to the band? like right as the last person passes. Alright, they're off. Do you want me to stay here because of the banner?
Good evening, parents, family, friends, and administration. Welcome to the 64th annual General McLean Commencement Ceremony.
Thank you for sharing in the wonderful evening. At this time, please rise, gentlemen, remove your caps, and remain standing for the playing of our national anthem and singing of our alma mater.
Beyond the lake's blue water stands our alma mater. Glorious to view the red and white, love and honor, praise to thee. We will sing of faith and loyalty, trust and courage guide thy days ahead. And we'll ne'er forget the Lancer, strive to win thee fame. Hail to thee, our alma mater, ever onward guard thy name.
At this time, it is my distinct honor and pleasure to recognize members of the audience who have served in the United States military. Will all members of the audience who have or are currently serving our country please stand and be recognized at this time? In the General McLean High School class of 2023, there are 6 students who have committed to the service of the United States of America through our armed forces. I ask that the following students stand and be recognized at this time. Brennan Joseph Benoit, United States Marines. Nicholas Gurlia Jr., United States Marines. Landon James Lasky, United States Army, West Point. Raymond Leslie Butler Musgrove, United States Navy. Dalton Orr Patterson, United States Navy. And Avery Christopher Young, United States Marines. The General McLean School District consists of 4 schools. Today's graduates have progressed through either McCain or Edinburgh Elementary Schools, James W. Parker Middle School, and General McLean High School. Together, the teachers in this district have provided the education and guidance necessary for our seniors to reach this milestone. Their united efforts have produced high-quality graduates, and their hard work has made us proud. Tonight, we thank our faculty, administration, and staff from all 4 buildings and ask that they stand and be recognized at this time.
As we gather here to celebrate our graduation, a phrase that perfectly portrays the situation is bittersweet. This phrase captures the conflict of emotions that are currently washing over us at this moment. It reflects both joy and sorrow, as well as excitement with a bit of melancholy. This occasion is bittersweet, but so was our whole journey throughout high school. All of us have experienced moments of triumph, from forming lasting friendships, creating unforgettable memories, and learning skills that will benefit us in the future. These sweet moments will have us thinking back to the good old days with smiles on our faces. Intertwined with these sweet moments are the bitter ones, the sleepless nights, the fights with our friends, and all the challenges we have faced along the way. There have been moments where all of us have encountered setbacks, faced disappointment, and questioned our worth. However, these bitter moments mold us into the individuals we are today. These important lessons have strengthened our character and taught us to overcome adversity. I want to remind you that it is impossible to avoid the bittersweet in life. Life is full of success and failure, joy and sadness, and laughter and tears. Embracing the bittersweet allows us to appreciate the full human experience and find meaning in its ups and downs. As we end this chapter and move on to the rest of our lives, I hope we all remember to savor the sweetness of our achievements and memories we have together. Think back to the late night cheats runs, the excitement before a game, or even just laughing at your lunch table with your friends. But we should also remember the bitter moments that have shaped us. Graduation is not the end, rather, it is the beginning for the next phase of our journey. Through this, we will surely experience the sweetness and bitterness of life. But in finding the balance, we are able to find ourselves and also create a life worth living.
What do you think of when you hear the phrase crash landing? I have a feeling many of us have the same picture in our imagination, and I'd feel confident in guessing it's something like this. A plane with an exploded jet motor or broken wings screams to the sky toward the earth at increasing speeds and crashes through the treetops of a forest or skids across a big empty field to a halt. Behind the plane is the aftermath of ruin and destruction as smoke and dust fill the air. Now, even if you didn't imagine something quite like that, I'd bet the crash landing scene in your head is certainly not pretty. Yet if I would have simply just said, picture a landing, most of us would have imagined a scene with a plane gently and safely touching down on a runway as it slows nicely to a stop. This creates the oxymoron. Certainly the phrase crash landing provides a contradiction. How can a crash, something unfortunate, dangerous, and destructive, simultaneously be a landing, something safe, gentle, and benign? Your perspective on a situation will affect which side of the oxymoron you find yourself, a crash or a landing. Life is filled with many challenges. I'm sure we've all encountered many and are well aware of those that will inevitably fill our future. Often these challenges make us feel as if we're crashing, as if there's no way that the situation can turn out okay. Or maybe a trial in your life has just ended and you're feeling like you've crashed down in a ball of fire and destruction. For instance, maybe you didn't get the job you were hoping for. Maybe you worked super hard on a school paper and didn't get the A you were expecting. Or maybe your car breaks down on the side of the road at the end of an already long day. All of these have the power to ruin your day, your week, and longer if you let it. Yet you'll find a positive perspective can shift your focus from solely the crash part and more toward the landing. Now, I'm not naive in trying to say that with the right perspective, all hardships and challenges go away. But through my experiences, I do feel there is power in a positive perspective. Yes, it will definitely be hard to choose a positive outlook at times, but it can make the most difficult situations feel more manageable. As we go on with positive perspectives, even when it feels impossible for there to be any positive at all, we will learn and grow from our experiences, and the difficulties that in the past would have sent us spiraling into a crash will begin to feel like just a little turbulence as we safely proceed to a landing.
Thank you, Kyle. When you think of perfection, you think of something that has no flaws, something that is completely flawless. Perfectionism can be regarded as an unrealistic expectation as well as an unattainable standard. It's not always necessary to be flawless because we are all flawed, and that's what makes us who we are. Flaws are what makes us unique. Every one of us will make mistakes in life at some point, no matter how big or small they may be. I believe what matters is how we deal with those mistakes once we've made them. Perfectionism is not something we should strive for. Instead, we should focus on our imperfections, embrace them, and learn to accept ourselves for who we are and what we do. I've always thought of myself as a perfectionist and how failure was not an option. But as I was writing this speech, I realized it was not possible. In order to learn, we have to fail and make mistakes. Throughout high school, I've had my fair share of failed assignments and tests, but it's through those failures that I realized what went wrong and how to fix it. So if we use the oxymoron, perfect imperfections, as a mindset, it'll help us grow as individuals. The oxymoron, perfect imperfections, is an excellent example of how we should live our lives. This is because all our imperfections make us perfect. We can't control what happens and must embrace what comes next. Our flaws can be a source of motivation and drive, and could also help us be more creative and innovative in our thinking. We can use our perfections as a tool to help us reach higher levels of success. While we may see weakness, undesirable features, and failures, others may see uniqueness, character, and potential. By embracing our flaws, we can grow and learn from our experiences and become even better individuals. Life is perfect as it is because there will always be flaws no matter how hard we try. By embracing our imperfections, we will get closer to perfection.
As we graduate and move forward in life, we may experience times when we feel uncertainty. We can't always predict what the future holds, and we often have to make decisions without having enough information. For example, at the great age of 17, we had to choose what we wanted to do for the rest of our lives. I think most of us can agree that we had no idea what we wanted to do. To be quite honest, I'm still not sure. In these uncertain times, a definite maybe can be an extremely useful tool. It's a way for us to admit the uncertainty about a decision, but still take a chance and commit to it nonetheless. Definitely maybe is the phrase I used anytime a family member or adult asked me about my decision on a college. There are two colleges that I struggled with choosing and knew they were each a strong potential choice. I had to remember that there is no one right answer. I accepted that I was unsure about my decision, but knew that any decision I made would be great. Ultimately, I chose to go with the one that is closest to home. Of course, I do not know if this is the perfect path, but I will figure it out, and it is exciting to take that chance. It's important to remember that there's no one-size-fits-all answer when it comes to a decision, especially about college or the future. So as we do draw closer to the future, I suggest that we don't hide from the unknown and instead embrace the uncertainty. I often find that the greatest rewards come from taking chances.
Thank you, Emily. A young child steps up onto a diving board and walks across until it reaches the end. He stands over the clear blue water below and watches the way it rolls back and forth. He leans over to get a closer look at the water when there is a loud splash followed by muffled yells. He flails his arms and legs and tries to claw for the surface, but he cannot seem to find it. Within seconds, there is a loud second splash, and he finds himself in his father's arms back on the side of the pool. In life, we will often find ourselves in stressful situations due to our foolish mistakes, where it seems like everything is on the line, and if we can't pull through, we'll lose everything. It's wise in those moments to make sure that we have someone or something on the shore to help us out. Years later, the kid is now back at the pool and once again looking into the water. This time, he knows the risks and doesn't want to fall in, but he sees how much fun everyone is having in the water. He wants to join them. He asks his friends for help, and they show him the steps into the shallow end. He walks into the pool and once again finds himself struggling to keep his head above water. This time, no one's jumping in to save him. But he's not struggling the way he did the first time. He claws and kicks, and he gets back to the steps. When you almost fail, it feels like you've learned your lessons and you need to avoid taking the risk again. But it's important to get back in and figure out what you did wrong. More time passes and the child is now almost approaching his teen years. He wants to learn how to swim, but has failed so many times. This time he asks for help and participates in lessons. He struggles to swim, but with the help of his instructors, he's able to learn from his mistakes in a safe way and learn the skills he desired for so long. It's important for us to continue to learn from those with experience in what we wish to learn. In life, we will make many mistakes and face many challenges, but making mistakes is the best way to learn. A wise fool learns best from his mistakes.
Thank you, JC. Hard work pays off, or so we've been told. We often use this statement to motivate ourselves to keep working towards our goals, but what happens when the hard work doesn't seem to be paying off? Sometimes we feel like we run the extra mile just to find ourselves back at the starting line. Well, what happens when we get back to the starting line? Do we keep believing that we will see the fruit of our work, or do we lose hope? Do we give up after losing the district championship, or do we work even harder and move on to bigger things? Do we settle for a mediocre senior slip and slide, or do we try again the next week working to create a better experience? Our answers to these questions say a lot about who we are and even more about the results we will see in our lives. There have been times when we've lost hope after not seeing initial results. We've stopped taking shots because we kept on missing the goal, or the hoop, or the award, or the grade. That's when we know we've failed, when we've lost hope and given up. Just because we haven't seen the results we've been hoping for doesn't mean we've failed, it just means we need to keep working. So yes, hard work does pay off, but results take time. Our results will not always appear within a day, week, month, or year. Sometimes our efforts pay off, but in very different ways than what we had imagined, and that's okay. Our goals may also evolve over time. We may not get what we initially wanted, but sometimes those losses allow us to gain something different or better later on in life. We have to learn to appreciate the initial results or any results that we earn. We have to learn to celebrate the little victories and use those victories as motivators for our next steps. We have to believe in ourselves, have hope for the future, and keep on working.
Should we take back Russell's camera? Yeah. Thank you. So what's his name now? Me? Alright, I'm moving to the podium.
As we reach the ending of this chapter, I would like to pose the paradoxical question, can something which is found be simultaneously missing? Today I would like to explore the nature of my oxymoron, found missing. For most times, found has a positive connotation, such as finding out you've just aced your test, finding a longtime best friend, or finding a great mentor during these past 4 years. While the word missing usually holds a negative connotation, such as missing out on joining a sport or club that has intrigued you, missing that grade you desperately wanted or needed, or missing the opportunity to chase what you truly desire. Throughout our academic endeavors, we have embarked on the quest to discover knowledge, seek answers, and most importantly, find ourselves. Yet it is in those moments of searching that we realize what we don't know, what is yet to be found, or what appears to be missing. In the vast landscape of our education, we have encountered subjects that baffled us, concepts that have eluded our grasp, and questions that seem to have no answers. We have felt the weight of our future's uncertainty and the frustration of not having the pieces to complete the puzzle. And yet, in that very void of understanding, we discover the spark that propels us forward. As most can relate, it is when we find what is missing that we find the ability to explore, to learn, and to grow. It is in the gaps of knowledge that our goal to understand is ignited, pushing us to dive deeper, to push boundaries, and to go against the grain. Think back to perplexing moments where you feel nothing is going right or makes sense, just to be met with the revelation that pieces your whole world back together. Reflect on times when you faced setbacks or failures, and through those experiences, discovered resilience, determination, and the capacity to rise above the challenge. For those are the moments when we truly find ourselves the most, and they tend to sprout in the face of what is missing.
Thank you, Aaron. Overbearingly modest. I would be remiss in a speech about modesty not to thank God and my family for the past, for everything that has led to this moment, the present, and for everything that will transpire in the future. Modesty, interchangeable in this context with humility, is a virtue that I have been taught repeatedly in my formative years. Humility has been, in the most positive sense, affixed to me and who I am. But in recent months, I finally realized that I have taken the idea of modesty to an extreme. I have been overbearingly modest, and being overbearing in the quest for humility is interruptive, as being too much of anything isn't modest at all. Although my intentions were rooted in humility, I downplayed my abilities, felt embarrassed by recognition, and underestimated my worth, all in an attempt not to be arrogant or boastful. I easily applauded others, but found it preposterous to applaud myself. Most oxymorons, when analyzed, display an appropriate balance. However, I feel that overbearingly modest is not sustainable and cannot be balanced. Instead, I offer another oxymoron, proudly modest, as a solution. To be proudly modest is to unashamedly acknowledge one's abilities and accomplishments internally so as to maintain the utmost humility. The proudly modest individual recognizes their worth instead of rejecting any and all indicators of their greatness from others. Fully believing in one's capabilities in such a way unlocks a quiet confidence as opposed to an extinct confidence. The transformation from overbearingly modest to proudly modest is one I am undergoing, and, as may be expected, I find much more peace of mind in internally acknowledging my accomplishments than in dismissing them, either inwardly or outwardly.
I now emphasize the necessity of conceding and celebrating my efforts, talents, and qualities, and I invite you all to share in this celebration with me today.
The General McLean School District joins with 11 other school districts to jointly own and operate the Erie County Technical School. Many of our graduates here tonight have completed one of the 18 programs offered at the school. They are wearing a green honor cord to designate them as ECTS students and were recognized in a ceremony on May 25th. We ask that our ECTS graduates stand and be recognized at this time. Students selected to the National Honor Society have demonstrated exemplary characteristics in the areas of scholarship, leadership, service, and character. The members of the graduating class of 2023 who have been accepted to the National Honor Society are wearing blue cords this evening. These students were honored at an acceptance ceremony during the school year and should stand and be recognized at this time. At General McLean High School, we feel a sense of duty and responsibility in the promotion of public education. General McLean students who are considering careers in education join the Education Academy as juniors. To gain experience in the field, Academy students spend a quarter at one of our district schools, and they offer assistance in district classrooms. Education Academy students are wearing red, white, and silver cords and should stand and be recognized at this time. The General McLean Academy of Medical Arts and Engineering is proud to recognize its eighth graduating class of the Academy. These students prepared for careers in engineering and the medical field by completing a prescribed curriculum, a job shadowing experience, and attending an advisory speaker series. These students are wearing red and white cords to designate them as Academy students and should stand and be recognized at this time.
Imagine this. It's a random Tuesday and you're at the Cleveland airport. You've just stepped into a freezing cold airplane and found your seat. Thankfully, it's a window seat, and you pull down the shade to block the bright sun from beating through the glass. You pull out something to do and get settled in for your flight. You're going somewhere, obviously. You're sitting down in an airplane and you've got comfy clothes on and headphones dangling from your neck. But with the hodgepodge of passengers shuffling around you and the shade pulled down against the bright sun, you could be anywhere. You could be going anywhere. But doesn't it also feel like you're going nowhere? Unless you look out the window or hit some insanely terrifying turbulence, you really can't tell that you're moving. You're sitting there going nowhere. This is a bit of a depressing oxymoron, but luckily for you all, I've figured out a way to put a positive spin on it. Although it may feel like you're going nowhere, you're actually on your way to a super cool place. In a few short hours, you'll step off that plane and right into a whole new world. I think the past 13 years have felt a little bit like this. Day by day, we feel like we're going nowhere. We wake up, come to school, do our homework, go to practice, and go home. The next day is the exact same, and the day after that, and the day after that, and the day after that. It's like you're sitting down in a 13-year-long flight and just crossing your fingers and hoping that you'll like your destination. Well, here you are. You're about to walk across this stage and get a little slip of paper to prove that you actually did something the past 13 years. And then what? You're getting off this airplane and hopping right onto the next one. And for the next however many years, you're going to feel like you're going nowhere again. But don't forget, just outside the shiny metal walls of everyday life, your life is changing for the better. No matter how hard it gets day by day, no matter if sometimes it feels like you're taking two steps forward and three steps right back, don't forget you are still going somewhere. So today, let's celebrate the end of a 13-year-long journey. Let's soak it all up. Tomorrow, we can get ready for our next flight. We can get ready to start all over again and go day by day to our next destination.
Thank you, Abby. What is one word to define yourself? Some may say right off the bat that they are courageous, some may say innovative, or even just outgoing. But I challenge you to think about the days when the courageous are cowardly, the innovative are unimaginative, and the outgoing just want to stay home. Filing an entire person away under a category of one word is difficult because there are so many different things that go into making up someone's personality. And people are more complex than one word can accurately define. Steel wool is an oxymoron because steel is strong and tough, and wool is the opposite. However, it isn't a bad thing to be both strong and soft, or tough and comforting. In fact, it's a good thing to have more than one side or more than one defining trait. A person's duality is what makes them unique, and the way a person handles something is what defines them. For example, if someone handed you a steel beam when you were cold instead of a wool blanket, it probably wouldn't make you any warmer. In our lives, I'm sure we've all met a person who we think is too nice for their own good. This person is wool, liked by everyone, well-respected, and it seems almost impossible for them to be unhappy. They don't seem to have steel days, or days where they just don't want to talk to anyone. They've become good at hiding their weak moments, which in the end can lead to worse results. In order to be successful in our lives, we must accept that we have strengths and weaknesses, or good and bad days. Individually, I've struggled to allow myself to show weakness in front of others. My wool side wasn't something I was proud of, and I honestly didn't think it was necessary for others to know that I wasn't flawless or that I had trouble with things that the people around me did without even thinking. I was steel in my outward appearance. I never asked for help even when I desperately needed it. But I realized that by not showing my struggles, I ended up struggling more. By embracing my wool side or my weaknesses, I've become stronger. I know what I'm good at and how to ask for help when I need it. I've learned that weakness in one area doesn't mean weakness in every area, and that just because sometimes your weaknesses feel all-consuming doesn't mean that you'll never have strengths again. It's better to be both steel and wool rather than just one or the other. It ends up working a lot better for you in the long run.
Thank you, Aaron. The reality of graduation today may not feel real to many of us yet. It may be because it feels like this day has come quicker than we realized, or that many of us don't feel fully prepared to graduate and move on with our lives. Nonetheless, it is a step forward that we must take. Through my eyes, tonight can be related to a level in Mario, with a level representing our journey throughout high school. And throughout this, we faced many obstacles. Among these obstacles, many have been like Goombas, and you have been able to overcome them easily. However, there have been many places in this level where you've encountered a baby Bowser, or Bowser, and have gotten stuck. Whether it be subjects in the class that just won't click with you, or disagreements with your peers that caused you to get stuck. But eventually, these obstacles had to be passed, and you moved on. Now, as you approach the end, what remains is the level at your back and the flag beaming in front of you. Tonight, it is time for us to make the jump to the flag. Overall, while this level may have brought many joys to yourself, it is important to move on. For in Mario, if we keep reliving or replaying the same level, then no progress will be made, and you must move on in order to progress through the game. While Mario is completely virtual, the reality is that you must keep progressing and accept what comes next in your life to become the better you. And if you constantly look back towards past memories, there will be no room for new memories or a new level. And although the future may be scary, as Barry Allen, the Flash, once said, things aren't always what they seem. Our fears can play tricks on us, making us afraid to change course, afraid to move on. But usually, hidden behind our fears are second chances waiting to be seized. Second chances at life, at glory, at family, at love, and these opportunities don't come around every day. So when they do, we have to be brave, take a chance, and grab them while we can.
The class of 2023 is the seventh graduating class of General McLean High School to be recognized according to the Latin recognition system. Students are wearing a pin this evening in the honor of their academic achievements. Students who have earned a cumulative GPA of 3.75 to 3.99 are being recognized as cum laude graduates. These students are wearing bronze-colored pins. Would these students please stand and be recognized at this time? Students who have earned a cumulative GPA of 4.0 to 4.39 are being recognized as magna cum laude graduates. These students are wearing silver-colored pins. Would these students please stand and be recognized at this time? Students who have earned a cumulative GPA of 4.4 or higher are being recognized as summa cum laude graduates. This year we have 10 students who have earned this title of summa cum laude. These students are wearing gold-colored cords and pins and are recognized in the program by a cross. These students are Eric Michael Kahn, Kyle Sherwood Cousins, Abigail Laura Greenleaf, Mallory Sailor Grusha, Erin Marie Menno, Shannon Shelley Rohr, Holly Clark Shreve, Emily Faye Swanson, Abigail Elizabeth Walker, and James Christian Williams. The General McLean High School Student Choice Award is presented to an outstanding senior selected by a vote of the members of the senior class. The General McLean High School Student Choice Award is presented this ninth day of June 2023 to Abigail Elizabeth Walker. The General McLean High School Faculty Choice Award is presented to an outstanding senior selected by vote of the General McLean High School faculty. The General McLean High School Faculty Choice Award is presented this ninth day of June 2023 to Aaron Alejandro Cornejo Lopez. The Corey Merzak Memorial Scholarship was created in Corey's memory. Corey had a wonderful sense of humor. He was kind, funny, and compassionate. He was a gentle soul and a friend to all. There is nothing Corey loved more than spending time with his friends playing and watching sports. It is the wish of Corey's family to award a scholarship in his memory to a senior who displays similar personal qualities and plans to pursue future study in a sports-related field. Corey had a love of all sports. The recipient may be planning to study sports management, as Corey did, or any other sports-related field such as sports recreation, sports communication and journalism, golf management, health or physical education, exercise science, and on. The Corey Merzak Memorial Scholarship is presented this 9th day of June 2023 to Ryan Michael Fiscus. The Lampson Award is presented each year to an outstanding graduating senior who has shown industry, perseverance, and enthusiastic attendance in his or her student life. The recipient of this award is chosen by nomination of the high school front office staff. The Francis Lampson Award is presented this 9th day of June 2023 to Frank Garen Bowen Terzak. The Administrator's Scholarship is founded on the deepest of gratitude and the belief that those who have been blessed have an obligation to give back. The scholarship is made possible by a fund created in the name of Therese T. Walter, who served General McLean as superintendent from 1982 to 2005. The intent is twofold. First, to thank the board and community who allowed the district to grow into one of the finest. And second, to thank the administrators who shared the leadership and the vision. Dr. Walter always said, "No one succeeds alone. If we succeed, we owe it to those who helped it happen." This scholarship is dedicated to those who helped it happen, and the recipient is the sole choice of the administrators at General McLean High School. The Dr. Therese T. Walter Administrators Award is presented this 9th day of June 2023 to Aiden Thomas Dugan. The Edwin J. Linden Memorial Scholarship Award is given in memory of the man who served as principal of General McLean High School from 1960 until his death in 1973. Edwin J. Linden was the first principal of the school following the consolidation and creation of the General McLean School District. He was a man of character who believed in people and in the importance of public education. The Edwin J. Linden Memorial Scholarship is the highest award which can be given by the faculty of General McLean High School. It is presented to a graduating senior who has displayed throughout his or her school career the same moral character, integrity, self-control, and discipline as was valued and practiced by the man for whom this award is named. The Edwin J. Linden Memorial Scholarship Award is presented this 9th day of June 2023 to Kyle Sherwood Cousins.
Good evening, parents, friends, family, teachers, and soon-to-be graduates of the class of 2023. As superintendent of the General McLean School District, it's an honor and a privilege to stand here tonight and present the class of 2023 for graduation. We're here this evening to honor and recognize these students for having completed an important chapter in their lives. And we also recognize that these soon-to-be graduates are here tonight because of the people in the stands. In many ways, tonight's ceremony recognizes your sacrifices, the folks in the stands, and all that you have done to support the journey to this stadium tonight. I want to take this opportunity to thank you for all that you have done to make tonight possible. The only piece of bad news that I have for the adults in the stands tonight, and when I think of them, I think of we and myself included, is that we were once able to humble and put younger folks in their place whenever they complained, because we would simply recount the challenges that we faced when we were young. We walked up the hill both directions to school in 3 feet of snow. We wrote on slate tablets with chalk in front of the candlelight, and all of those different things. I don't think that works so much anymore because the class of 2023 had to equip themselves in hazmat suits and submit a DNA sample just to go to geometry class throughout their high school career. So I think they have us on that one. But class of 2023, as I'm sure you've realized over the last 4 years, while you've completed both high school and weathered a global pandemic, our lives are filled with moments that are significant and mundane. In case you didn't know, tonight is one of those significant moments. In other words, tonight is kind of a big deal. When you step off the stage tonight, after you get your diploma, the ground under your feet is just a little bit different. It's a little bit different because you are then a graduate of General McLean High School and a lifelong member of our GM family. And when I talk about our GM family, I think that there is something important to remember. When we talk about the GM family, our family, like all families probably, we're an imperfect family. And although we may be an imperfect family, we are in a perfect place. And when I talk about us being in a perfect place, we are in a place that values you. We value meeting you where you are. We value empowering you to become the best version of yourself. The idea of you, this you that you are here tonight, is why we do what we do. We value you and who you are. Class of 2023, you had to work incredibly hard to realize this potential that we saw in you. Your high school career was more or less bookended by normalcy. I mean, you almost made it through your normal freshman year. Not quite, but you almost did. But in between that freshman year and your senior year, things got a little bit crazy. But despite all of that, you persevered, you adapted, and you persisted. Class of 2023, more than any other graduating class in recent memory, you got to experience it all. And when I say all, I mean all the things inherent to what comes next in your adult life. The challenges, the joy, the unfairness, the love, the normalcy, the loss, and the unpredictability. What most people experience over a lifetime, you had the opportunity to experience in 4 short years. You condensed into a crucible of high school all of these experiences. And what emerged from that crucible, this version of you, is what you're prepared to be whatever is next. Author Oscar Wilde reminds us, be yourself, because everybody else is already taken. And I encourage you to embrace and to lean into this you that you are now. This idea of yourself, and who you've become at this conclusion of just this chapter in your life. When I say embrace this version of you, that does not mean that you are done. You're not done growing as a person, far from it. You'll have relationships. You'll live in places and experience things that will determine the course of your life. But at your core, be proud of you. Because if somebody has not told you, in short, I'm telling you now, you are enough. The you that you are now is enough. And please don't forget that. Whatever comes next, please remember that you have earned this day, you are enough, and you have earned it. So before moving on this evening, I want to say thank you to the class of 2023. Thank you for being the young adults that make us proud to say that you are graduates of General McLean High School. At this time, I'd like to recognize and welcome the members of the General McLean School Board. Board members, if you could please rise and be recognized when you're introduced, and audience, please hold your applause to the end. Mr. Brad Petullo, Mr. Kevin Weber, Mrs. Dana Miller, Mr. Luke Lofgren, Mr. Andy Schultz, Mr. Don Ickes, Dr. Timothy Wise, Ms. Sherry Gold, and President Carrie Crow. And now President Crow, as superintendent of the General McLean School District, I am especially proud to present to you the General McLean High School Class of 2023 for the rite of graduation.
Good evening. Like you, many of you, this is a little different because I actually have a grad here and I have, I've gotten to know so many of these adult citizens who soon shall be authorized to graduate. But this has been one class to watch, and I don't know if you were born under a special moon or you, maybe your parents, maybe we just did a really good job with you. You're a little bigger class. Your light shines a little brighter. And this group has always been much more self-aware and situational awareness. You've always done a little more. There's something special here. And I think it lends to what Dr. Lane was saying about what you've gone through, because even your speeches tonight are remarkable and full of wisdom. And I'm not just talking about the kids on this stage, okay? I want to talk about a couple other kids out there. I know there is Kira Schoolcraft, who had nothing to say up here today, but you are here because you are an extraordinary artist and you're going to make a solid living doing something with that talent. And Angelina Domeyer isn't just an impressive because she rocks that hairstyle. She's the best welder in Erie County and got an award for such at the Erie County Tech School, and we should honor her for that. That was a big deal, so thank you very much. You got a big one there, Angelina Domeyer, so thank you. Graham Harrison, who proved that Ms. Hurd, thank you. Let's give a hand to Angelina. That was a big deal. Stand up. That was a big deal. All right, and then we got, you know, I'm going to tell Graham Harrison, who proved that Miss Hurdle is truly a saint because he is a successful Erie County Tech School trained mechanic who is already working full-time and out on his own. And sometimes your lives, you've already solidified your track and you're ready to take that next step. But unfortunately, you had to wait until 6 p.m. on June 9th. So the bright side, I guess, is you learn patience here at GM in your senior year. Because some of you wanted to be here, and I'm sure there's a lot of you that just made it. Some parents made a deal, and some of you probably did not want to be. Show of hands, who had to get forced to be here tonight? Yeah, and somebody made deals. You know it's out there. I'm sorry. But you're not done learning, and whether it's an institution of higher learning, a workforce, or the battlefield, you will have many jobs, you will have many cars, you will have many adventures, many experiences, and you will change your mind about so many things in coming years. But give yourself a break. You have so much pressure on you, and it really isn't fair. Give yourself space to learn and the grace to make mistakes. Because you're going to make a lot of mistakes, many, many mistakes. And you're going to use that self-awareness, I'm certain you all have, to turn those mistakes into lessons. And then take those lessons and create blessings. And then take those blessings in your life back to your family or whatever that might mean in your future. But then don't delay and give back. And I guess that's where my faith is in this group and why I think you are so special is you are so tuned into the need to get engaged and make things better. And yes, we have our Kyle Berkmeyer breaking records, running faster, or the girls' soccer team going all the way to the States, or our team's team going to the state competition this summer. That's fantastic. The national competition. But what is so obvious about this group is that these citizens, way more than the usual lot that I've ever seen in any graduation I've ever attended, you have taken extra initiatives to do something for the common good or volunteer your time for various causes, and it is remarkable. Meaning you have already made the decision to make our world a better place. I mean, take Ross Morrow, raising funds for a worthy cause before he was a teenager. That's a good guy. And I literally don't know what we're going to do with the Holiday Arts Fair this year because I've had some of you since kindergarten, and that's true. Kaylee Porter, is in my phone under Kaylee, thank God, because when I need her, she calls and I say, Kaylee, oh, thank God, we need quarters at the front table. Or, Kaylee, thank God, are you on your way here? Because we've needed you. We've needed the volunteers, and you got to keep that up. It is so important. And if you want to have a productive society, you got to educate your people. But if you want to have a quality of life for your community, you must volunteer. You need to give back. Find the fundraiser, the event, the causes, and something you're already interested in wherever you go, wherever you land, wherever you call home, for whatever reason. I don't know why, but it will come back to you. Volunteering pays off. You meet people in high places with common goals, and good things come from these efforts. Plus, it looks really good on a resume. So pull some off if you can. And as a parent, this was our one day. But to you graduates, tomorrow is day one. And you're in charge now. And you can be anything you want to be. But make good choices. And go forth and be good citizens. And call your mother from time to time. And so on behalf, it is my great honor, on behalf of the 9 members of the Board of School Directors of the General McLean School District, it is my sincere honor to hereby declare that the scholars of the General McLean High School class of 2023 have met all the requirements established by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the General McLean School District and are now authorized to receive diplomas and be considered graduates of General McLean School. Congratulations, Lancers, you have done it.
River Williams Adams. Riley Mackenzie Adamski. Kyler James Blaze Alexander. Alexis Elizabeth Avery. Abigail Grace Ball. Tyler James Banks. Allison Isabel Bannister. Marissa Ann Bard. Colton Joseph Bartow. Nicholas James Bowder. Sydney Claire Bale. Samantha Marie Bennett. Brennan Joseph Benoit. Philip John Berger. Abigail Grace Berquist. Kyle Matthew Berkmeyer. Leave Elizabeth Bookhammer. Frank Garen Bowen Terzak. Carter Ryan Boyd.
Michael Thomas Broderick. Maya Christine Brown. Miles Ray Bruce. Rayleigh Shea Berger. Samuel Lewis Kane. Bailey Sue Cannon. Anthony Thomas Carmesino. Nathan Sean Carpenter. Brianna Mackenzie Chalk. Ray Violet Chemsack. Leo Chen. Tyler Allen Chorney. Brennan James Clarkson. Eric Michael Kahn. Garrett Chapman Coolidge. Aaron Alejandro Cornejo Lopez. Elaine Catherine Corwin. Kyle Sherwood Cousins. Caitlin Marie Crosscut. Lucas Daniel Crow. Dylan Dennis Crum. Emma May Dahlstrand. Diane Nicole Danilowitz. Jasmine Nicole Day. Stone Nicholas DeFelice. Kara Christine Delaney. Brianna Joy Dine. Angelina Nicole Dobmeyer. Aiden Thomas Dugan. Josephine Violet Dufferin. Haley Lynn Dunham. Kalinda Ray Ivankovich. Jack Roger Farkasovsky. Sydney Catherine Ferraro. Luke Philip Fetzner. Delaney Catherine Fickle. Ryan Michael Fiscus. Haley Elizabeth Fisher. Wesley Clayton Fisk. Madeline Violet Foridori. Haley Bliss Fresh. Talon William Frick. Mina Lene Fugate.
Brock Cameron Geyser. Oshin Richard Glenn. Jade Desiree Graves. Zachary Matthew Green. Abigail Laura Greenleaf. Mallory Sailor Grusha. Lauren Elizabeth Guild. Nicholas John Gurlia Jr. Nathan Wayne Hagstrom. Abigail Faith Hammer. Gabriel Sterrett Harrison. Graham Lee Harrison. Heaven Lee Hartson. Brady J. Haskins. Clarissa Marie Higby. Isabella Marie Hinkle. Tristan Michael Hubble. Reagan James Humes. Justin David Ivorone. Toby Ann Ingram. Ryan Michael Jankowski. Allison Elizabeth Jones. Michael Matthew Cavalish. Rhiannon Sky Kilbasa. Michael Aaron Kimmy. Shayla Colleen Kinniston. Chloe Angelie Kaiser. Mariah Marie Krieger. Cole William Kiefer. Emma Jean Kulisic. Skyler Paul Kianvash. Caitlin Sarah Langer. Eamon Alexander Lanier. Landon James Lasky. Rachel Elizabeth Lesher. Nicole Rose Lipinski. Logan Michael Lutch. Shannon Lisa Marquis. Owen Sander Martin. Joshua Edward Matuszewski. Dylan Zark Mayer. Tyler James Mayo. Aiden Michael McClelland. Abigail Lynn McIntyre. Emma Veneva McLaughlin. Erin Marie Menno. Alana Mary Mercurio. Robert Anthony Messenger. Kaylee Grace Meyer. Jada Danielle Meyer. Katrina Maya Miller. Justice Rodney Miller. Alexandra Jacqueline Montgomery. Liliana Irene Mook. Meredith Francine Moore. Kayla Phoenix Morris. Ross Bradley Moreau. Riley Rose Munger. Raymond Leslie Butler Musgrove. Dana Nicole Myers. Marin Catherine Olone. Landon Robert Olzeski. Isaac Allen Orr. Savannah Sky Orzechowski. Leah Ann Owens. Alyssa Paige Parsons. Dalton Orr Patterson. Dylan Orr Patterson. Braden David Pershka. Kaylee Bella Porter. Lyra Rose Prost. Colin Joseph Rapella. Jacob Hayden Rao. Kendall Michelle Reichard. Riley Nicole Reichard. Brooklyn Ann Respecki. Shannon Shelley Rohrer. Henry Benton Salvo. Kira Riley Schoolcraft. Nicholas Christopher Shrub. Dylan Lewis Sheeter. Grant Isaac Sherman. Holly Clark Shreve. Pavitar Singh. Anna Louise Sisson. Casey Leigh Smith. Noah Stephen Smith. Wilson John Spires. Jonathan Allen Steele. Jesse Douglas Stempka. Michael Paul Stroop Jr. Sean Tyler Stutz. Layla Jade Sullivan. Emily Faye Swanson. Edward Allen Sychuk. Samuel Hunter Tedesco. William John Thomas. Trey Nathaniel Trezona. Ivan Allen Tucker. Nadia Danielle Tashashni. Mackenzie Rose Vogel. Abigail Elizabeth Walker. Jace Robert Walls. Kara Elaine Walter. Madison Nicole Weed. Isaiah Robert Wells. Cooper Benjamin Williams. James Christian Williams. Noah Scott Williams. Emily Jane Wismer. Caden Jared Wright. Maxwell Jack Peter Yeager. Avery Christopher Young.
Class of 2023, please stand. Congratulations, we did it.